And we have another visiting from the LC, and I just met Mars yesterday for the first time. Please give your name, Mars. Bhakti Sundar Goswami Maharaj. So we'd like to ask him please to say a little something to share with us about how Prabhupada is inspiring you. Haribo.
Haribo.
Sala Prabhupada ki. Pancha kalpa taro yascha kripa sandhyam deyo vacha patita nam pava deyo vaishnavyo namo namah. So we are all made of Srila Prabhupada's mercy and compassion. Once Prabhupada said in Los Angeles that this movement spread beyond my expectations. So his Guru Maharaj, Prabhupada, asked Prabhupada to speak only in the English language, but Prabhupada went beyond that. He went even to South America, Mexico, Russia, so many places, far away places. So I was fortunate to meet Prabhupada in Venezuela, South America, in Caracas. He just came from Mexico, and was the second Spanish-speaking country, and the only two countries Prabhupada visited in the world. That generation on the 60s, 70s, we were looking for some spiritual solution to our existential problems. We wanted to know what is the truth, why we are suffering, what is the purpose of this life. And we see everybody around us just crazy making money to enjoy life and become more materialistic. We thought, must be something else beyond that. So that desire, that hankering, and I remember sometimes used to lament why I wasn't born at the time of Jesus. I could be a follower, to learn more about God, and some or other, Krishna in the heart, very, very mercifully heard that prayer. Jai. And he led me. Jai Shri Mataka Maharaj ki.
Jai.
So, but still, impersonalism was there, no understanding about God's personality. And I used to lament about it because I thought that God must be, must have a form, must be a person, but I don't know anything about it. So, and I told one friend once, and we were together in a vegetarian restaurant, that before meeting the devotees, I told him, do you see this ugly gray building from the window? This is made by man. And do you see these beautiful roses here on the table? These are made by God. If God can create such beautiful things, imagine how much beautiful must be God. But I have no, I want to know him. And the day I come to know him, I will surrender to him. And my friend said, that's very nice, but take it easy, So, a week later, I met a devotee in the streets of Caracas. One new devotee, he was not even initiated. And he gave me an invitation card. When I talked to him, you are vegetarian, you must come to our vegetarian Sunday feast, love feast. It's wonderful, to come with your friends. Anyway, we went there. And the first thing I asked the devotees when I entered the temple, can you please tell me how God looks like for you? And immediately they showed me a beautiful painting of Radha and Krishna, and they said, here is God. And I thought to myself, why not? He looks very beautiful. So my idea of God, he must be beautiful. And I thought to myself also, all religions of the world are looking for God. And this Hare Krishna people has his picture hanging on the wall. That's really far out, So anyway, immediately start chanting, you know, and a few months I moved to the temple. But when Prabhupada came to our temple, we were expecting him even a year or 2 years earlier, because he was always writing letters, yes, yes, I want to go visit there. For some other reason, something happened, you know. He came to Atlanta and his health wasn't good, so he decided to go to Los Angeles for better weather, whatever. And still didn't get better, so he went to Mayapur. From Mayapur, he was writing letters to Caracas that, yes, I will visit. Finally, when Prabhupada came to Caracas, so many devotees came from all over Latin America, and even from the US, Canada. And I remember at the time of initiation, Prabhupada called me, and when he gave me the name, he started to explain the meaning. He said that Jagat means the universe, the world, and Chakshur means the eye. And you are the servant of the one who sees everything. And he gave a brief explanation, you know, to the audience that you should always remember that whatever you are, whatever you're doing, you must feel God's sight on you. And then Prabhupada looked at me and pointing his finger, he said, "You cannot hide from the eyes of God." I remember even the tone he said it, you know, like, get fixed in my mind, you know. And everybody was looking at me, oh, maybe he did something wrong. And I thought, well, Prabhupada's really in my mind, because the day before, after Mamalarte, I went to the kitchen, and I stole the maha sweet thinking nobody's watching me, and hid somewhere to eat it. When Prabhupada said that wow, we can see everything. was very, very wonderful experience with Prabhupada. And the next day, I came earlier from Sankhya. From the first day I joined the movement, I came one evening and decided to join the temple. Next day in the morning, the devotees put a dhoti on me, and they, you know, I told myself, I hope my friends will not see me with this pink skirt or something. Anyway, so the day after initiation, I came and we're going to the Brahmacharya ashram and passed through the garden. And to my surprise, was Prabhupada sitting on his wheelchair and his rocking chair in the garden, and suddenly I was face to face with him, and I paid my obeisances, and Prabhupada looked at me and I looked at him, and he just moved his hand like that, "What do you want?" And I felt like a little nervous what to do. Yeah. So I thought he was gonna, you know, chastise me, so I just said, "Oh, Prabhupada, I just came from distributing your books in the city." And Prabhupada immediately asked me, "How Venezuelan people like my books?" And I said, "Prabhupada, very much. As soon as they read your books, they become very favorable to our movement, and they keep asking me for new titles. No, this one I already read. There is one, we want a new, more." So Prabhupada moved his head like that. And he said, "Come with me." So his room was next to us, you know, where he was sitting. So he entered the room, I followed him behind. And on the table, he had a tray with sweets, and he took a sweet, and he handed me the sweet and said, "Thank you for helping me." Wow. Yeah. And I thought to myself, I was crying actually, I felt, oh man, just a new volume, Robert, so compassionate, you know. And I thought to myself, he's telling me, "You don't need to steal the sweet, I give it to you." Although Prabhupada stayed only 7 days in Venezuela, there is a video actually by Yadubar Prabhu. You can see it. Prabhupada had so many, you know, wonderful pastimes there with different people, even animals. Prabhupada went to the park one morning. Every day we would go with him to the park, very nice park. I don't know if Balavanta Prabhu visited that park. He was in Venezuela. I met him first time there in 79. And when Prabhupada hears some birds crying, so Prabhupada asked why they're angry. Chutakirti told him, oh, they are in the cage. Prabhupada said, only birds? No, there's a whole zoo here in the park. Oh, let's go see the zoo, Prabhupada said. So we followed Prabhupada and he went to see the zoo and he stopped where there was a pond with crocodiles in it. So we were surrounding Prabhupada and he was looking at the crocodiles. One crocodile was like a statue, you know, on the sand, and two were swimming, you know, in the pond. And one of them took his head out and looked at Prabhupada and opened his jaw big like that. And Prabhupada looked at him and Prabhupada spoke to him. Prabhupada told him, you have very good arguments to catch, but there is no opportunity to catch. And he looked at us, Prabhupada said, he's male. I don't know how Prabhupada just by looking, he knew that wasn't male crocodile. And Prabhupada said, he's inviting, one of you must come here. And the crocodile just closed his mouth and opened back again, and Prabhupada told him, no food. And we were laughing like that. Prabhupada's humor was unique. Even Prabhupada spoke Spanish. Well, one lady told Prabhupada in the park, buenos dias, señor. Prabhupada asked, what does that mean? So Prabhupada explained, that means good morning, sir. Oh, okay. And after, you know, a few minutes, you know, some people were coming, you know, and group of, you know, they were doing exercise or whatever, and Prabhupada, to our surprise, told them in a very clear Spanish, buenos dias. All of them answered, Prabhupada, buenos dias. And even when he spoke with the Metaphysical Society, he mentioned to give, they were impersonalists. I mean, not only impersonalists, they were saying that, they were arguing with Prabhupada that the name of God is I am. That Saint Germain advised them for the Westerners to chant I am, not Hare Krishna. So Prabhupada was arguing with her that, okay, I mean, Jehovah is a name, Allah is a name, Christ is a name, but I am is not a name. And they were arguing, no, no, in the Bible, supposedly God said, when Moses asked him, who should I say, who sent me? And supposedly say, I am who I am. Prabhupada said, that's okay, God can say I am, and you can say I am, but your I am is not the same as this I am. When God says, I am means I am the supreme, and when you say you I am the small particle. A rich man may say I am, and a servant may say I am, both I am are the same. The woman said, well, in essence we are all one, we are all the same. Prabhupada said, essence means spirit. God is the Supreme Spirit, and you're the tiny spirit. When the Bible, it is said, Prabhupada called it the Bible, that when God said, let be creation, immediately creation happened. But if you're hungry and you say, let there be chapati, no chapati. You have to sweat to work hard together. And then Prabhupada quoted Bhagavad Gita and everything. And at one point, he told them, after Amara was reading Bhagavad Gita to them, and Prabhupada picked up immediately and said in Spanish, Alma and Super Alma. Understand, Alma means the soul and Super Alma the super soul. So Prabhupada told, there is a difference. And finally they accepted. Prabhupada said, okay, bring prasada. So it was very wonderful. I mean, just to be with Prabhupada is like an aura, you know, like, give us fearlessness and protection from Maya's influence. And many new devotees sometimes ask me, what you feel, what you felt when you was personally with Prabhupada, you know? So it is a very, very unique experience, you know? And of course, you are very fortunate, you can see the videos and you can hear the lectures and everything, you know? I mean, and you have, you know, a Prabhupada disciple, you know, with wonderful memories talking about their